arms. And we'll go the other direction. You guys can keep warming up. I need to adjust the tripod just a little. Switch your arms. Okay. We're doing both directions on our arms. Good, we can do some swings in front of us. Really get those shoulders nice and warm. And then when you're ready, we're gonna work into our legs. We're going side to side. And switching legs. Good. Now we're going to go front and back. And switch legs. Good. Then we're going to work into our hip hinges, feet shoulder width apart. Slight bend in our shoulder width, slight bend in our knees, and then we're pushing our butt back, keeping our back torso nice and straight. Really just the hinge at our hips here. Loosen up those hamstrings, feel it pull up into your glutes. We're doing about 8 of these. And then when you finish up those, we can work into our body weight squat. Your feet might widen out just a little bit. Weight stays in your heels as we squat down, getting our thighs parallel to the ground. Make sure you're holding resistance in your knees. They're not coming in toward together. If anything, they're gonna track a little bit out. Do about 3 more of those. I'm gonna start explaining the exercise. So we're starting with our squat thrusters. So for this one, you're gonna need just 1 dumbbell. We're gonna hold it at our waist, and we're mimicking those squats we did to warm up. So holding that weight even with your chest, we're squatting weight in our heels, holding resistance in between our legs, and then as we raise, we're gonna push that weight overhead. So this is gonna be a powerful movement as we thrust the weight up. From there, we're gonna go reverse fly to a front raise. So you're gonna want both of your dumbbells for this one. We're gonna go into that hip hinge. First movement, we're doing a reverse fly. So palms are gonna face each other. We're gonna lift our elbows to the ceiling a bit, but we're pulling between our shoulder blades to fly. From there, we'll go palms down and do a front raise. So we're gonna just lift those weights to even with our shoulder. Staying in a hinge, we fly out to the side, lift out to the front, fly out to the side, lift up to the front. Then you can keep both dumbbells in your hand, and we're going to do our RDL split squats. So for the first 30 seconds of this, our right foot is going to be in front. We're going to have just a really slight bend in our knees, and here's where we want to think about keeping our back long. So keep from the crown of your head out through your tailbone long, weight stays on both sides of that right leg. We extend down, feel the pull in our hamstring, push into our heel to stand up. We should feel this exercise in our glutes and our hamstrings. So all along that posterior chain, our back, 30 seconds right leg, 30 seconds left. Then we're gonna do a core pass. So this one you can do with a weight. Or you can do without, and you're gonna feel it the same. The weight, like everything, is just gonna add resistance. But essentially what we're gonna be doing is passing the weight from our feet to our hands. So we lay out, sit up, pass the weight from in between my feet to my hands. If you have a heavier weight, this may be more difficult. So without a weight, you can just pretend that you're passing a piece of cloth back and forth between them, okay? So we'll do that for 30 seconds, and then we'll do plank walks for 30 seconds. So we'll get in our high plank position. We're walking 3 steps to the right, and then 3 steps to the left, holding our plank position, back and forth for 30 seconds. Then we hit burpees. When we do get into that Tabata, any variation you need, if jumping's too much, then you can just do a calf raise, come up on your toes. But if you can jump, we'll jump, high plank, step or jump your feet back, push up if you want, step or hop your feet in, and to the top. So we'll work 20, rest 10, work 20, rest 10. But first, we're starting with 6 minutes, and we're just doing those top 6 exercises for 30 seconds, but I will cue you guys into what we're working with. So to start, I want you guys to grab 1 dumbbell and get ready for your squat thrusters, okay? I'm just gonna put the clock behind me, and then we're off. Okay, let's start. 30 seconds, we have squat thrusters here. We're just warming up. Trying to increase our range of motion in our hips, knees, ankles, shoulders, wrist. We'll try and increase our reps this next round, but take your time getting familiar with the exercises here. Grab both weights. Hinge at your hips, palms together. We fly to the side, then lift to the front. Fly to the side, lift to the front. Stay with it. We have 12 more seconds here. Core is engaged here. Back should feel rigid. So you should feel like your back is engaged all the way through your low back. Good. Step right foot in front, just slightly, slight bend in your knees. And we've got our split stance already out. Feel the pull in your hamstring. Weights stay nice and close to your leg. They can rub the outsides of your legs the whole way down. Then you push through your heel as we raise up. Good, we're switching legs. From here, we're working down onto the floor. We've got that core pass. Before we get there, we've got about 15 more seconds with this left leg forward. Five more seconds. If you guys have like a towel or an extra shirt laying on the ground by you, you can use that as we go to our back to pass between you. You don't even need anything really, but sometimes just the visual is good. We extend our legs and arms out with every pass. Keep working. Feel that core contracting. Pulling your arms and legs up. Good. We're flipping over. We've got plank walks. Hands are staying under your shoulders. Butt stays down. 3 walks to the right. 3 walks to the left. Whatever pace you need. In 6 seconds, we're hopping back up for squat thrusters. And let's go. This time through, we're trying to increase our reps. Feel comfortable in the movement. We got this. Push your heels into the ground. And use that power that you're generating in your legs to push the weight above your head Excellent. Both dumbbells. Reverse fly to front raise. Palms face each other to fly back. And then palms face your body to raise out in front of you. You'll have a slight bend in your knees here. Three more seconds. Good, right leg slightly forward for a split stance RDL. 70 to 80% of your body weight should be in that front leg. You should essentially be able to mimic this movement if you were to lift that leg off the ground, but we're using it for stability. Good. We switch legs. Same deal. Chest stays big, so we're not rounding our shoulders forward. We're keeping them pulled back. You should start to feel all those major muscles really warming up for you now. Getting ready to fire, we go to the ground. We have that core pass. Arms and legs straight out with each pass. Keep working. Good. And we get into our plank. Last 30 seconds. Here we go. Three to the right, three to the left. Butt stays down. Try pushing your heels to the back wall. That's going to engage those quads. Three, two, one. Hop up. If you need a quick sip of water, grab it. We've got about 10 seconds, and we're hopping into that Tabata burpee. So we're working 20, resting 10. And we're starting in 3, 2, 1. Let's do it. We've got 20 seconds here. Count how many you get in this first 20 seconds. And try and keep that number each round we go. And relax. We got 10 seconds. Catch your breath. And we go again. Hop or step your feet back. Do a push-up. Take whatever variation you need here. 5 more seconds. And relax. Woo, we're a third of the way there. 5 more seconds. 3, 2, 1. And relax. Halfway. And we go. Just keep yourself moving here. Doesn't matter if you get one in, I just want you to keep moving. And relax. We have one more minute here, and we go right into our squat thrusters. And go. Whoa! I kicked this ball behind me. 5 more seconds. And relax. 20 more seconds of work here. And then we're done with those dang burpees. Let's go. You guys got this. Halfway. Last 5. Get 1 more in. And relax. Well, not necessarily. Grab your weight. We've got squat thrusters. You got this. This leg should feel burn by now. Push beyond it. Good, both weights. Fly to front raise. You got this. Push your weight through your heels on this. Engage your core. Make this an arm workout. Good, right leg forward. Split stance RDLs. I want you to think about always seeing 6 feet out in front of you. That's gonna keep you from tucking your chin, rounding your shoulders forward, and help to keep that back nice and long. Good, switch legs. Your toes of the back foot should be just about in line with the heel of your front foot. Really isolating that front leg here. Good, to the ground. We've got that pass from hands to feet. Lots of nail work. Ten more seconds here, and we go into our plank walk. 3, 2, 1, flip over. Get those hands under your shoulders. Last 30 seconds, and then we have a break. Keep working, last 10. Butt stays down. 3, 2, 1, relax. Whew. Excellent. We're a third of the way through. Get a sip of water. And we're moving into that second column. While you guys recover for a minute, I'm gonna jump in and explain these exercises. So, okay. We're starting with weighted boxers. So you're gonna grab your dumbbells for these. We're just gonna box 30 seconds. I'm not a fighter, so I don't really know the right way to punch, but I want you to put one leg in front of the other. I do know that makes us more sturdy. And we're just pumping, punching for 30 seconds. You gotta uppercut someone. You can mix that in if you wanna hit them with the cross hook. Do that, just punch for 30 seconds. If your weights are too heavy, that's okay. You can work on just getting your heart rate up by socking somebody. From there, we keep one dumbbell. We go into a half squat, and have tricep extensions. So with the dumbbell behind your back, we lift the butt straight up, firing the back of our arms up our triceps. Then we grab both dumbbells again. Reverse lunge with the bicep curl. We just step back, curl at the bottom, come up, switch legs. Boom, easy enough. Back and forth, back and forth. From there, we're gonna work into side plank variations. We'll change what we do in the side plank each time, but I'll let you guys know. This first one, we're gonna do an oblique crunch. So you can have both legs out, but I'm gonna keep one knee under me. From there, our hips stay stacked. Hand comes behind our head and we use it only as a guide. Then we lift up, knee to elbow, crunch that oblique. 30 seconds on the right side, 30 seconds on the left. The last exercise is a boat hold with leg lift. So we start sitting, then we tilt back. That engages that core. You should be really on the top of your tailbone here. Your hands can come back for support. I think you'll want them for 30 seconds. And our legs come up to tabletop. From here, we lower our legs and bring them back up. So we're not moving our upper body. We're just firing our core up to go back and forth. When we get there, Tabata will be skaters back and forth, okay? 6 minutes, we got the exercises two times through. We're starting off with boxers. And let's do it. Let's show them what we're made of. Stay in your legs. That's going to keep you athletic. Core's engaged. You can do little quick jabs, crosses, uppercuts. Just keep yourself moving. Feel your shoulders start to burn, your biceps, your triceps. You should feel your lats. Two more seconds. Good. Drop one weight. If your weights are lighter, you can hold both. We do a half squat. Extend the butt of that weight straight up to the ceiling. Your legs should start burning on this. Your triceps. Five more seconds. Good. Both weights, reverse lunge with the bicep curl. Weight stays in your toe, in the ball of your foot, on the leg that's stepping back. We keep nice shoulder width distance between our feet. Good. Down into a side plank. You can have your knee under you. We have the crunch this time. Then we extend that leg straight out. Keep working. Five more seconds, and all we're doing is switching sides. Good. Other way. That knee should be stacked right under your hips. Your hand should be directly under your shoulder. Your knee and elbow aren't coming out in front of you to crunch. You continue a nice straight line. We're just firing up those obliques. Excellent. To our butts. We have the bolt hold with our leg raises. You have the option here to take your hands away and just hold boat with that leg raise. If you want to just try holding boat, you can certainly do that. Good. Hop up, grab your weights. Start sucker punching someone. Get that heart rate up here. Feel strong in both your chest and your back. You got this. 10 more seconds, burn it out. Good, drop one, wait. Squat down, triceps. Let's bring our legs together for this one. Feet together, knees together, but we stay in a squat. Oh yeah. 5 seconds. Good, both weights. Reverse lunge, bicep curl. Shoulders stay back and down here. Elbows stay in tight to your rib cage for that curl. Ten more seconds, and we're a side plank. We're gonna do a rainbow with our leg. So just think if you were to draw a rainbow with your toes over your hips. So we're in that same position. Foot comes in front, up and over, to the back to the front. Feel that glute, especially that outer glute, your lateral glute working for you. Hands under your shoulder, knees under your hip. Good. Switch sides. You're pulling your hip up to the ceiling by firing those obliques. Ten more seconds. Good. Into the boat. Hold with legless. If you need it more intense, lean back. More. Force that core to engage for you. Nice and slow here. Feel the burn. Last 3, 2, and 1. Quick 30 seconds. And then we've got 3 minutes of skaters, baby. And then the exercises again. Last 5, 3, 2, 1. Skaters back and forth. Stay low and in your legs. We're just working for 20. Try and get high rep count here. Back and forth, back and forth. Good, relax. Loving the jam that's on. 3, 2, 1, go. We got this. I'm sure that you guys having me sing is helping you get through this workout. Relax. 1 minute down. Three, two, one, we go. 20 seconds. If you can, increase the distance in your hops. It's a good way to vary your intensity. Three, two, one. Halfway through. We got this, gang. Tell you what, your butt's on fire. 3, 2, 1. Five more seconds. Relax. Ah. 40 more seconds of work. Keep it up. Let's go. Halfway. Relax. One more. Catch your breath. Push yourself. Here. Last bit of skaters. Let's go. Keep going. Keep yourself hopping. You got this. We're halfway. Last five, all out right here. Relax. Grab those weights. We're punching. Right now. Stay solid in your core. Make these short, powerful punches. 3, 2, 1, drop a weight. Squat, we're going feet together, knees together again. Triceps behind your head. Sink those hips. Do not let yourself rise out of this. You have 10 seconds. You can hold that. 5, 3, 2, 1. Both weights. Reverse lunge to a curl. Keep going. Ten more. Good. Side plank. We have dips. Legs out. Stacked or staggered. High or low. Drop those hips and pull up with your oblique. Five more. Good, switch sides. Stay steady here, you guys. Feel those obliques, your side bodies firing for you now. Three, two, one, boat pose. Legs up to tabletop. They lower slow and controlled. Fifteen more. Last 5 seconds. Stay with it. Good. Relax. Good little core burn there. At the end of that, I'm gonna grab a quick sippy sip. Then I'll explain these while you guys recover. Take the time to get nice big inhales through your nose. Exhale through your mouth. Dumbbell swings. You know I can't go without them. Option to do one or two. If you have two, they'll be on the outside of your legs. One, you're gonna swing in between your legs. Movement's the same. Feet shoulder width apart. We hinge our hips backwards. We aren't squatting them back or down. We hinge them back. Our arms will naturally go back. Then we fire and snap those hamstrings and glutes up Momentum carries our weight. We stay solid there for 30 seconds. Then we drop straight to our knees. Both dumbbells still in hand. Shoulder press. Press. Hips forward. Weights are going to be resting on our shoulders, palms face out. And we press up. Lower. Press up. Lower. Core is tight. Feel the burn on the top of your shoulders. Then we drop to tabletop for weighted donkey kicks. You'll tuck that dumbbell into the crease of your knee. Hands will go under shoulders. Knees under hips. Curl your toes under. Lift the heel of that leg to the ceiling. Boom. 30 seconds right, 30 seconds left. From there, we have alternating leg crunch. We're going to go to our back. Both arms straight up. We're going to crunch. Bring our right leg up, back, left leg up. Nice and slow here. Just one leg at a time, alternating. Last exercise, reverse plank hold. We just are gonna push ourselves up. Legs go straight out. We're just planking with our chest up. Hold that for 30 seconds. Tabata's gonna be mountain climbers. Hands on the shoulders, high plank position. Driving our knees. Last group here, gang. We got 6 minutes. Grab your dumbbell or bells and let's start with my favorite exercise, swings. Here we go. Weight stays in your heels. Think legs here. Feel legs here. Draw your brain to that part of your body. Three seconds. We drop into our kneeling position. Let's go. Shoulder press. Palms out. Nice and controlled. Hips are forward. Force that core to engage. Oh, yeah. Three, two, one. Tabletop, one weight. Behind that knee, tuck your toes. We have donkey kicks. One single leg right now. Keep your hips parallel to the ground here. Try to minimize any pelvic tilt. That can be accomplished by, you guessed it, engaging your core. Lift your belly button to your spine. Feel like you're wrapping, switch your legs, the deepest part of your abs. And that you're squeezing your rib cage closer together. Nice and controlled here. Nice visual is that you're hitting a tack in the ceiling in with the heel of your foot. That's what we lead with. So remember that next time we go to our back, we have alternating crunches. Legs straight out, hands straight out. And we're crunching. Opposite legs. Lowering in control. Five more seconds here. Three, two, one. Lift yourself up into that reverse plank. Push through the palms of your hands. Lift your heart to the ceiling. That's the easiest way to think about it. You can push your heels into the ground to lift your hips to the sky. Five seconds, we grab our dumbbells for swings. Three, two, one. Let's go. We're hinging and firing. Good work, you guys. Three, two, one. Kneeling, shoulder press. Palms out. Breathe in here, 10 seconds. Good, tabletop. Hands under shoulders. Tuck that weight into your crease, curl your toes under. We lift for donkey kicks. And now we're gonna pulse. Small movements at the top. Quickly. This isn't your full range of motion. Good. Switch. Full range of motion. Full donkey kick. We pulse in 3, 2, 1. Pulse at the top, pulse at the top. Quick, powerful. Feel the burn, little movement. We're here for 5 more. Good, alternating crunches. Both arms out. Nice and slow and controlled down. Ten more seconds for you guys. Reverse plank in 3, 2, 1. Up. Palms and heels push against the ground. We lift our hips and our heart to the roof. Stay sturdy here. You got this. Breathe. 10 more seconds. Do not let yourself sag. Relax. Quick drink. We got 30 seconds. And we're meeting in a high plank for those mountain climbers. And we go in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Push it here, you guys. 3 minutes of cardio. You've got that in you. Three, two, one. Relax. Stay solid here. Trust your body. Know you can push through this. Hands stay under shoulders. We go. Butt stays down. We are off. Keep working. Relax. Good work, you guys. 1 minute down. 2 to go. We go in 3, 2, 1. Driving those knees. Keep yourself moving here. I don't care what pace. Relax. Halfway. Do some arm circles here. If those shoulders feel like they're burning a little bit. Go. Butt down. Grind this out. Relax. 1 more minute. Push through this. Last bit of cardio. Let's go. I'm making us stay here for 45 seconds. This is our last push. We've got it. 30 more seconds. Stay where you are. This should be hard, you guys. You got it. 15. 10. 10. Woo! Excellent work. We have a quick 10-minute recovery, but we're meeting at the top for dumbbell swings. We go in 3, 2, and 1. Dumbbell swings. Oh yeah. Shoulders are feeling it. Good. We're kneeling. Shoulder press. They weren't feeling it then. They're sure as heck feeling it now. Hips forward. Keep working, you guys. We have 2 more minutes of work. Good. Donkey kicks into tabletop. Full range here. Feel like you're squeezing at the top of this movement. Ten more seconds and we switch legs. Hips stay parallel. Good. Switch your legs. Fifteen more here, and we flip onto our backs. Good, to our backs. Alternating leg crunch. Nice and in control. In 5 seconds, we lift ourselves up. Into reverse plank, here we go. Heels in, palms in. Lift your heart, lift your hips. Ten seconds. Five, four, three, two, one. We're not done though. We're doing 2 minutes Tabata jumping jacks. Here we go. Start. 20 seconds with me right here. Push it. We have 2 more minutes. Make them powerful jumping jacks. Big range of motion. Work through this, you guys. Relax. Quarter of the way done. 3, 2, 1, we go. We're all here together right now. Five more seconds. Relax. Woo! 3, 2, 1, go. 20 seconds right here. You've got that. Relax. Whew. We are just about done. I promise this time. We go in 3, 2, 1. Push it right here. This is the end. Do not let up on your intensity right now. 10 seconds. 5, 3, 2, 1. Woo! Now we're done. Now you can get a drink of water. Whew. We're gonna stretch it out. And then we can call it a night. Excellent work, everyone. Sorry for springing some things on you, but makes us better. We'll just meet on the ground today. We'll start with our arms. Cross one over. Excellent. We'll switch. Now we'll stretch our triceps. We gave them some love today. Oh yeah. Switch. Good. Now we're gonna take our fingers, lace them together behind your back, and push the palms of your hands into the ground. This should open up your chest. Good. Now we're gonna go the opposite way. Interlace your fingers, push them out in front of you. Round out top of your back. Feel the pull between your shoulder blades. Excellent. We're gonna roll onto our back here. We'll start with the figure four. Cross one ankle over your knee. If you need a little bit more of a stretch, you can grab between your leg and pull that knee into your chest. Switch your legs out. Good. Now pull both knees into your chest. I want you to roll up just slightly here and bring your forehead to your knees. Really feel that stretch from the base of your neck down through your tailbone as your spine curls. Good. Now keep your knees locked together, ankles locked together, stack those knees on top of your hips, tee out your arms and rotate nice and slowly, side to side, thinking about that spinal rotation. You'll go about 3 to 4 times each direction. And that is what we have for class today. I hope everyone enjoys their weekend. Hope it stays nice. Get out. Do something in the nice weather. And I will see you guys for class on Monday.